So yeah, I mean, it's we I earlier in the day speaking about the structure of a long novel, it does help to have this kind of abiding gateway that you're going to use, and in this case, it would be the consciousness of the narrator.
How easy was it to write in such distinctive vernacular?
Well, I think most writers are, I would hope, were interested in language their whole lives, right? And I certainly have been, and so that probably makes me more sensitive to nuances in the way people speak and the way certain people speak and slang, like you said. And so it probably I enjoy that more than the average person. So it just seems natural to recreate it best you can.
To what extent is this an American novel?
It seems to me a particularly American viewpoint, because it's a particularly American problem. America incarcerates a higher percentage of its citizens than any other country. So this is in many ways the prototypical American novel. It's not set in an English department of an Ivy League school. It's set, essentially showing what's happening in a world that's probably rarely depicted.
What next?
All right, so I wrote another novel that doesn't really have much to do with the criminal justice system. I'm at work on a third book right now, again, a novel. And this one incorporates, I mean, there's a place called Rikers Island in the United States. It's a fascinating place, I'm finding out. And substantial portion of it deals with that. And I'm also currently fascinated by professional football, what we call, well, you not soccer, what we call American football, where people run into each other very violently. And so let's just say it kind of merges.
Has Hollywood come knocking on the door?
I create this, real strong division, where I concentrate on writing, and then, my wife handles all that other stuff to, and she'll tell me if something requires my input in any way, but I generally try to stay out of that.
Does your wife read your books?
Yeah, I mean, my wife is in many respects the reason for the book's existence. I had a lot of trouble finding a publisher. And it was she who basically convinced me to pay to self-publish it way back when.
What was it like self-publishing?
I don't know. I don't know how to characterize it. I would say I wasn't particularly happy with having a self-publish a Naked Singularity. Let's leave it at that. It didn't seem, let's say, it didn't seem justified.